All right, YouTube. Part 4 of my Let's Play Vampire Masquerade Bloodlines. And I was just dancing a bit here in the club with my vampire friends, and this weird looking dude with his weird looking mask and tattoo on his back. Anyways, let's move away. Oh, they all stop dancing now. Well, I'm running another errand for one of the sisters, Jeanette, who wants me to destroy some paintings of a rival faction. So let's go and do that, I guess. Okay, so we're outside the asylum. There we are, and I'm off to the museum, but before doing that, I will show you guys the character sheet. This is where you can distribute your experience points. I think I got 6 here, so I could use another one on strength. Let's see what else. The higher the attributes, the more experience points they will cost. So let's see if there's one that only costs 2. Not a whole lot. Not really. Right. Well, anyway, let's find the museum. Check the map first. Let's see. Twelve. Not really close to it, so go to the other side of the city, basically. Yes, I think we have to go this way. Let's check the map again. I'm right here, so the museum is quite close now. A little bit more to my left. Yes. Here it is. Maybe there's a back. Whoa!
Hey, hold on a minute there. I'm afraid you're committing a 351. That's trespassing on private property. I'm gonna have to ask that you vacate the premises immediately, or I'm afraid I'll be forced to radio this in. Sure. Yeah, I can do that. Right this way.
All right. Thank you. I intimidated him.
Bad boy, bad boy. What are you gonna do when I come?
Need some crazy pictures. Let's see if I got a knife to destroy these. Huh. weird. I guess I need to do it in a sort of order. Yes. Now, which one should I take? By God. Abel, God. This should be it. Oh, gee. What's that? Oh, God. I need to fight this dude. Try this again. The combat is somewhat simplistic. It's just button mashing. But I'm trying to kill it. I've activated my power of fortitude, which means that I can enduring more damage. I'm gonna win this. There you go. Right. I destroyed the paintings. I destroyed it. Alright, so, let's see. Okay, so I slashed up the paintings. Now what? Maybe I should just head back to Jeanette. I think. See if we can. Okay, and end up in the back alley. Let's go back to the asylum. Here. Yes, that's there. So there are numerous ways of approaching a mission. You can either brawl yourself inside or not. I'm trying to sneak inside, but heading back to Jeanette. So there's some backtracking to this game, but, you know.
You thinking? The museum. That was my event. Did you think I wouldn't find out? Shut up. I thought I could control my sister as long as Tun was out of the picture, but nothing's changed. I should have expected that you'd succumb to Jeanette's influence like all the others, but how dare you? Don't lie to me. Jeanette already confessed she tricked you into doing it. It was probably all Tung's idea. I'll deal with them later. But that's still no excuse for you ruining my museum. Excellent. I'll take that. However, Jeanette claimed you did it for her. But let's say I believe you. After all, you've acted decently and rationally up to now. I imagine you'd still like me to call off the feud. There's only one problem. If Tung gets word that I threatened Jeanette, which he most certainly already has, it's not likely he'll believe me. So, in order to call off the feud, you're going to have to convince Jeanette to forgive me first. I made some threats against my sister. Idle threats, involving fire and her impious satin sheets. She took them quite seriously, and is avoiding me. I want to meet with her, and explain that they were said in the heat of the moment. I asked her to meet me at the Surfside Diner to reconcile. But I'm busy with the club and my other endeavors. I'd like you to go to the diner and promise her that I don't plan to take any action against her. Wait for her in the back booth, near the phones.
Okay. Well, now I'm involved in some kind of sisterly quarrel.
For all her unwholesome diversions and irritating disruptions, I should be less tolerant of her. She is my sister, however, and I suppose I'm obligated to forgive her her trespasses. I did sire her, after all. Please, be quick about it.
Well, let's head back to the diner. Right, there's the diner, right in front of the Asylum, or Asylum. Well, let's go inside. Okay. Oh. Dude, these guys are looking strange. Yeah. I don't think they're up to no good. Well, I think up to no good. Weird. What's he doing? Looking at a pan that's being burned on the stove. Interesting. Let's go to the telephone booth. Oh man, what the fuck? Holy crap, they're shooting.
Where you going, man? Ah!
Oh man, there's another one coming. There are two coming. Oh, these knives are pretty potent. It's laughably crazy, the combat in this game. Can I pick up the gun? Yeah, I think so. Oh, cool. Oh, there's a telephone ringing somewhere.
I'm terribly sorry about that. My sister was just furious about your refusal to take part in her designs, so she sent those men to kill you. But I'm going to make sure it never happens again. Drop by. We'll take care of this tongue business.
She's crazy! Help!
Well, I'm not sure what he's doing. Let's feed on him. Uh-oh. Oh well, let's go outside. Okay. I'm not moving. Is he gonna shoot me? What's he doing? Should I go running? Okay. Oh man. Hopefully they won't find me here. Giving up. Let's head back to the sisters. Whoa.
You stay out of this. To think anyone would risk their life for this filthy, tainted waste of blood. This will just make it easier to kill both of you.
Help! Save me and I'll help you find Bertram! I swear!
Shut up, Jeanette! I warned you to stay away from Tongue. He's turned you against me. I always looked out for you, but you couldn't stand my success. You had to meddle, didn't you? I didn't want it to end like this, but you forced me! You never gave me any credit for anything, Therese. I was the one calling the shots. Bertram was dancing on my leash.
How does it feel to know that I beat you? Isn't it obvious? I'm about to rid the knight of this deviant, backstabbing whore. Do you realize that despite her condition, she still fornicates with kind, no less? So despicable. So unclean. You're one to talk, dear sister. Or should I say daddy's little girl? Do you want to know just how depraved the Baron of Santa Monica can be? Shut up, Jeanette. You'd love the world to think you're a saint. When you thought I was asleep, I used to hear Father come in at night. I heard him whisper how much he loved you in your ear before he... Don't finish that sentence, or you're dead.
Right, so she's sort of getting so frantic. Well... Looks like I need to choose between the two of them. I like Jeanette better.
Had his way with you, and he didn't have to force you. You went limp and became his plaything. Do you think I didn't hear it? Night after night, always the obedient daughter until... Shut up. Just shut up! Would you like to tell the story? She makes herself out to be the Virgin Queen of the Night, pious as a nun, stable as the Earth's orbit. But it's all an act, isn't it? I'm the good girl. You're the wicked one. You've done nothing but plot against me when I had our best interests at heart. And despite that, I've always covered up your mistakes. I've taken care of you. And this is how you repay me? Taken care of me? You've done nothing but keep me down, blame me for every mistake. Did you expect me to let you rule my life until the end of time? No, sister. You've had it coming since our last sunrise. Is that right, dear? If it wasn't for me, you would have never survived this long. Remember? They tried to separate us, but I refused. I chose this life and brought you into it so that we could stay together. Obviously, you've forgotten. She's a control freak. People, things, emotions. If she can't control something, she gets rid of it. And you're a wild animal. You'll rub up against anything that'll take you in for the night. Then when you're stuffed and bored, you bite the hand that fed you.
Hmm.
As I said, to trust Jeanette is to trust a famished jackal not to eat you while you sleep. Therese will never let you live. You've disappointed her. I used you, yes, but I didn't try to have you killed. Therese has no problem with killing, do you? Remember Father? Father loved me. I was a good girl. I always did what I was told. You always hated that he loved me. You disobeyed him. You brought men home when he wasn't there. You were an awful daughter to him. Father came home drunk one day and mistook me for Therese. Because I'd fallen asleep in her bed. Don't listen to her. She's lying. Therese walked in while he was there, and she saw me lying with him, and so she went to the closet and pulled out his hunting shotgun, loaded it with deer shot, and blew his mind out all over the silly clown wallpaper. That's a lie. Father killed himself because of Jeanette. She made him miserable. As I recall, he died with a smile on his face. The police sure did. They broke us up for a little while, remember? The first thing you did after your escape was find me. Enough! Don't say another word about that. So, sweet sister, is this how it has to end? I admit, I always knew this night might come. Well, any message you want me to give Father? An apology? A love letter? I should turn this on you next, but I won't. Without Jeanette's assistance. Tongue, you're no threat. I'll call off the feud if that will get you out of my city.
That was weird.
Tongue's hiding out in an abandoned oil tank at the old gas station. I'll tell him that one condition of a truce is that he help you. Our business, then, is finally complete. What you witnessed here, not a word to anyone.
Well, that was strange, but interesting. Okay, now what? All right. Let's head over to Tongue or find him in an oil tank. See if we can find him. Where, oh, where can that be? Okay. Oh, this looks like an oil tank. Oh, I can open. Well, well, well.
Look who finally made it. Thought you'd never find me, huh? I've gotten good at knowing when I'm wanted. The one and only. But don't bother with the introductions, fledgling. I know who you are. News travels down the Kindred grapevine like wildfire. And that courtroom spat between LaCroix and Nines Rodriguez is a juicy little morsel. And you in the middle. How interesting. Oh, you did you? Well, I wasn't worried. So why did you need to find me? What did you need? Oh, never mind. The warehouse, though. I've been watching the place. The Sabbat has a bunch of low-life humans working day and night to move stuff through there. There's some major staging going on. The Sabbat. Jeez, you are green. It's like this. We're all monsters, like it or not. I'm not gonna say the Sabbat are the evil vampires, because none of us are the good guys here. But the Sabbat, they glorify their monstrous nature. They refuse to hide it. And go out of their way to show it. They're also brainless and reckless. They have a life expectancy of a vampire fruit fly.
Well, that's interesting, because so you're sort of introduced now to different factions of vampires in this city.
As far as I can tell, the humans seem to know the score from the way they've been talking. I think most of them have aspirations of joining the next graduating class of shovelheads. Ugh, losers. Yeah, the Sabbat like everyone to know just who they're dealing with. So if you get in there and have to bust a few heads, don't feel bad. Think of it as upholding the masquerade. Yes, I can. Just tell me when you're ready, and we'll leave. Once you're there, however, you're on your own. You'll have to get into the place and plant the explosives in the middle office to take the whole structure down.
Alright. So here we are, and this is where I leave you guys. See you in the next episode of Vampire Masquerade Bloodlines.